It's about time.
What's going on? Yo.
Rumor report, rumor report.
This is the Rumor Report.
Talk to him.
With Angela Yee on The Breakfast Club.
All right, well, it was announced that Tyrese and his wife, Samantha Lee Gibson, were getting divorced. That was filed back in September, but now Tyrese, it seems, wants his marriage back. Now, he left a comment under Tammy Franklin's post. That's Kirk Franklin's wife. She had posted, "Last night's anniversary dinner was all that I prayed it would be, small and intimate, yet full of laughter and love. God is indeed so good. The Franklins, 25. And Tyrese said, "Happy, happy anniversary. Magic, magic, and more magic. Dear Samantha, this was supposed to be us. Remember, the Franklins was our marriage goal. Smiling, smiling. I'm going to get her back. Watch me, I think." And looks like he's going to really go all out to try to get his wife back.
If you, as a woman, Yee, would you want that to play out in public like that? Because we didn't, their troubles didn't play out in public. So should trying to get her back play out in public?
For her, I don't know what her thoughts on that are. Some people like public displays of affection and they like, listen, our breakup was, you know, listed publicly. I want you to do that. I don't know if they've been in communication with each other, if she wants the world to know. I don't know why they even broke up, truthfully. So I think it depends on certain people. Certain people are very private and they don't like that. But if he knows her well enough to know that she would appreciate a gesture like that, maybe she saw it and started crying. Maybe they hadn't been communicating. This was the way for him to make a grand gesture. Yeah, who knows?
That's true. Maybe they haven't been communicating. And this was the way, hopefully, you know, she'll get to see it if that's what he's trying to do. But I know they've been going through, I know she wanted money, more money. He didn't want to give the money. So some of it has been public. So hopefully they can work it out.
I will say this, Envy. You haven't been there for Tyrese the way Tyrese has been there for you.
I was thinking the same thing.
No, you got to pull up and DJ. Same way.
Yeah, I think you should DJ like a romantic dinner.
I called him. I spoke to him. I called him. He didn't answer me. I texted him. I DM'd him. He hit me back with my, and that was it. He didn't. You know.
Why would he send you Johnny Gill?
I don't know.
Why did he say that?
That's wild.
I don't know. But my wife reached out to him. You know what I mean? I was kind of hard on him with the text, though. Pause.
By the way, if he replied back to your wife but not to you, I got to see them hands, bro.
You got 5 minutes for you.
All I need is two.
Just 2 minutes. Now, he didn't reply to either of us. So, you know, I'll continue to reach out to him. I hope he's doing okay. I just want to let the brother know that I'm on his side and I'm here for him, just like he was there for me. And yes, if I have to go DJ while she walks out, I will do it.
Okay.
And for people who don't know, when Envy was going through a tough time with his wife, Tyrese sang Sweet Lady, right? Was it Sweet Lady? Oh, no, Stay. He sang Stay.
Yeah, Tyrese was... He was definitely one of my coaches during the time when I was at my lowest. Him and my brother Rashid, they were both, you know, there when I needed them, and I always appreciate that, and I always mention and talk about it.
All right, now Dr. Dre, you know, he's going through his very bitter divorce with his estranged wife of 24 years, Nicole Young. The other person that he's estranged from is apparently his father. In an interview, his father, Theodore Young, said that his son wants nothing to do with him. He said, "I haven't seen Andre since his grandfather died, and I can't even remember when that was." This is according to Page Six. He said, "We have no relationship. My other sons love me. They tell me they love me, but coming from where I come from, most young men like Andre, who have a big success, don't give a damn about their dad." So not sure what's going on, but being the fact that he could have just died now, I'm hoping that they resolve all of these family issues that they have.
That's probably why he's bringing that up, though. You would feel that way if your son, you know, you thought your son almost died.
Mm-hmm. All right, now Jennifer Lopez did an interview with Jay Shetty on Coach Conversations, and she revealed how therapy actually helped her in ways that she never would have imagined. Listen to this.
I remember when I was like going through therapy at the beginning, kind of like in my late 30s, there was a lot of talk about loving yourself, and I was like, I love myself, but obviously I was doing all these things in like my personal relationships that didn't seem like I was loving myself, but so I didn't even understand the concept of it, and it took time, and it's a journey, and it's still a journey for me.
That's a fact. Therapy is a game changer. I've been going once a week for 4 years. I'm a big proponent for therapy. I tell people that they definitely should go to therapy. But I'll tell you one thing, too. You know, once you've been going to therapy for a while, you have to start adding the actual mindfulness practices to your therapy. So now I incorporate meditation. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Because, you know, once you have the language for what it is you're going through, you have to actually have certain practices to do the work and really, really heal in a real way.
Gotcha.
All right, and shout out to Teyana Taylor. She has dropped her first collection with Pretty Little Thing, and it looks really good. It's inspired by her own signature style. which is very 90s. And, you know, she said, I wanted the collection to be fun and reflect the way I dress. The new collection is where girly and tomboy meets. All right. Well, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your rumor report.
All right. Thank you, Miss Yee. And shout out to Ludacris, too. They stole Ludacris's Benz yesterday. He jumped out to go to the ATM, and he said by the time he turned around, they was literally rolling out with his car. So shout to Ludacris, and man, bring Luda back his car, man.
And that's exactly, come remember on, earlier, I said I'm at the point in my life where I keep nothing in my car. Mm-hmm. Because I feel like if people rob you, then they have access to addresses and all that other stuff. That's exactly why. So, yes, Luda, I understand you. Salute to Luda. Get that man back his car. But that's exactly why I don't keep nothing in my car.
All right, now, let's get into the mix. Revolt, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Of course, this is the anniversary of Kobe Bryant's passing. So it's only right to start off with some dedication records to Kobe. One from Wayne, one from Fab. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.